And I just want to say, I want to thank Mark for asking us to be a part of this. It's really amazing, and it feels really good for us to be able to help out like this. So thank you, Mark, and thank you, Rachel, for what you've been doing. It's amazing. Change gears a little bit, a little more worshipful. You probably know this, so welcome to sing along.
Thank you. nourishment in healing. It's another song we're taking and kind of getting our own by a man called Sanctus Rio, but the song is called Something Heavy.
Generous tonight in giving to Rachel's house. So we're going to go ahead and whoever's going to be handing out the buckets, we're going to do that. But Deborah's going to share a couple thoughts.
Okay, first I wanted to announce that on September 29th, we are having a fundraiser at Arrowhead Country Club. You can go on Eventbrite and register. You can pay on that site. It also has the meals that are available for that evening, and you can pick what it is that you choose to eat on that night. Another thing I wanted to share with you is, I wanted to share a little bit about a girl who just graduated from our house. She didn't stay as long as we wanted her to, but she is a success story. She came after the pimp that had her, had beaten her severely. Actually, her partner, he left her for dead, and he had beaten her. Vice brought her to our house. She went through our program for 5.5 months. She basically got her life back. She was in college. She was had a job. She was working and got caught up with this girl, with this guy. And you can see on the table that we have information about how they groom the girls and how they show you that they care about you and they love you, and it's all a facade. But she was, we put her back in college. She started going to school. She ran into a cousin and met up with her family and was restored to her family. So we were excited that she came and she got her life back and she found her family. So that's one success story I wanted to share today.
Thank you, Deborah. And thank you all that we're able to get tonight. And we just want to pray that God will bless the funds that we're given to be used to help these women.
Next, we're going to have Joy. She's going to come and sing a song for us. And come on up, Joy. She's kind enough to agree to help us out today. So we're glad to have you. So how about a hand for Joy? That Mark's going to sing back.
Thank you.
Thank you, Tim. Where are you going off to? He's coming there. Now we have a special treat. Mark's going to play, and Aggie's going to play Indian flute.
This is an old spiritual. It's called an English spiritual. And speaking of old songs, I learned this song from an 8-track tape of a Tennessee Ernie Ford album way back in the 60s or 70s. Wayfaring Stranger. It was a signature song of Burl Ives, so it goes back a little ways. One day we were just strumming, these guys were, and I just started singing the song and just took it from there.
Song, and we were working on it together, and it was a Christian song.
never could finish the song. And then 2 years later, finding out that he was going to the CCC church, and I didn't know that at the time. I know he was attending church, I didn't know which one. But it's like full circle. I ended up coming to this church, hooking up with Travis, and then we finished the song. And it's called "It Ain't Too Late to Do the Right Thing."
Thank you.
TV today, there's too much violence on my newsreel page.
Also, I just want for the radio listeners, anyone listening through a podcast, to know that if you're listening at any point along the way, you can always give to Rachel's House. They're always in need of gifts, financially or otherwise. Do you have a way to get
them? They have a website, ForgottenChildrenInc.org. And you can go, pay with a MasterCard or Visa. There's an address at the website where you can send a check if you like. So we just want to encourage anybody listening. This is a tremendously important ministry. Let's do everything we can to support Rachel's House and Forgotten Children.